XM Nation Awards comedy section. Comedy Big Shtick Award for the most popular routine or joke of the year.
Ah.
Have you heard of this bit?
I'm going to guess this is my bit about Islam.
No.
Is it Jimmy doing his... And is that it?
No.
No, I think this is... Oh, I know what it is. I got it.
Yeah?
Frankis!
No.
Gotta be. The winner is Frankis.
It has to be.
No.
Aha. When I hold the mic by my asshole and fart and shit.
Come on. How could that not be?
It would be.
What is it?
It would be Craig Shoemaker and his Love Master bit.
Oh, I'm happy for him.
Are you about shitting me?
Well, I don't think I've ever heard it.
I've heard of it. I bet he's been doing it for years.
What is
I've
it?
Heard
his,
it?
His staple bit. It's like Bob Nelson's football player bit, but not that, as famous.
Yeah.
Or as funny.
Well, I want to. Do we have any Craig's bit?
I've heard it.
Bill's got some. Let's hear some.
The Love right, Master. Let's take a listen. What the fuck is this?
Oh, no.
You know what this is? This is it? It's like Bill Shaw.
I was walking down the street, feeling real incomplete. Watching the babes go by.
Were ya?
One after another, I heard them all mutter.
He ain't much of a guy.
Well, my head started hissing that something was missing. Maybe I'm
holy
acting
shit.
Too nice.
You gotta be shitting me.
Stop, I...
So I walked down an alley to see a seer named Sally to give me some love advice. And she said,
listen, mister, don't get your head in a blister. My answer comes quick as a wink. To master life, one must master love. That's the way you should think.
Okay.
Looking at you.
Oh my God.
You shouldn't feel so blue. You've already got what they're after. Forget about the money. This one's on me, honey. You've just become the love master.
There we go.
Ew.
Love master? Why don't
feel any different? Oh yeah.
That's this is a joke,
bit.
Right?
Move over, Rover.
That's his bit. He puts on the low voice. He says he's a love master.
Wait, I want to hear where it goes. Does he say something?
No.
Oh, yeah. You hear that ringing, baby?
That's the most popular routine or joke? XM has some great comedy.
What happened?
I have more respect for the fucking decision-making of Jonestown. XM Nation stinks.
As a nation, we do stink. We're a third world nation when it comes to taste.
Oh, Jesus.
What the fuck was that? Would you ever take one of your bits, Jimmy, and turn it into a song? Could you do that, please?
Ugh. No. What, you know, what, no.
Isn't it? But he actually does the Love Master bit.
That's what I thought Bill was going to play.
And then that's the song that.
And he decided the bit was so good and so scary funny that it deserved to have a song made out of it.
All right. Enough already. The song Most Beaten to Death by Broadcast. Yes, James Blunt. You're beautiful.
Yeah, beautiful. She's just a big girl.
Female stand-up champion of 2006, that would be Lisa Lampanelli. She had a good year.
Yeah, I mean, look, as far as what women comics are doing, at least she's up there fucking brutalizing people, so good for her.
She also won Most Black Cock.
It's true, she beat out Robin Givens. And, you know, she's fucking, she does a lot of racial jokes and stuff like that, and she does them on TV, and she does what she wants, so.
Yep.
All right, let's say hi to Chuck in South Dakota. Chuck, what's up?
Yeah, that Craig Shoemaker, if you guys listen to his bit, not that music crap, it's actually a pretty good bit.
Well, do we have the bit, Bill? That's what I thought you were going to play. So that was out of Bill's iPod, so I don't know where, but he got...
All right, here's the actual bit.
It's actually pretty funny.
So this is funnier than the song we just heard.
Let's...
Okay.
All right.
What are you laughing at?
I'm the love master, baby.
Yeah, catchphrase. Oh, it's a stairway to heaven.
Don't you laugh at the love master, baby. I'm warning you. I can chip your tooth from right here, baby.
I'm as cock. Hard as Chinese algebra. That's right, baby.
Stop it. No.
As hard as Chinese algebra.
Well, that caller said that it was funnier than the song.
No!
Well, maybe there's a better...
He didn't say that.
No!
Is there a part where he says more chins than a Chinese phone book?
Got more chins than John Liu's office.
Oh, my God. That's one of the hackiest...
Oh, my God.
Let's hear another line. Let's hear another line, too.
Maybe it was just one.
Yeah.
Master love, baby. Yeah. What are you laughing at back there? I'll stir your drink from right here. Yeah, I got a drink. It's a penis colossus. That's right, baby. Yeah. You want to take a picture? Set that camera on panorama, baby. Yeah, I'd show it to you, but it's caught in my shoe. Yeah, I'm the love master, baby. Yeah, I'll flip you so much you'll think you're at IHOP. That's right, baby. Yeah, I'll have your knees knocking like a Jehovah's Witness on a pledge drive. That's right, baby. Yeah, one night with me, baby, you'll be sweating like Jessica Simpson taking the SATs. That's right, baby.
Oh, no.
Master love, baby. I got 4 inches right.
My stomach right now is dropping like a pregnant Lacey with a baby in her belly.
Does that make you embarrassed to be in the business?
It's just, to me, it's like, dude, I know you want to be clean and family friendly, but what you could, like, I'll flip you so much you'll be at an IHOP? What does that mean?
They flip the pancakes there, not the people. See, it doesn't...
But why would you think, like, all right, this guy's fucking me really well, and he's turning me in different positions. I must be in an international house of pancakes. I don't get it. It's like, again, you want to be clean for tea, but...
Dude, no, this is just bad. It's hack. It's fucking old shit.
I'll knock your tooth out?
Well, he's going to be on our show soon.
No, he's not.
No.
Even a big cock hitting your face, would that knock your tooth out?
Knock anyone's tooth out. A cock is generally, even when it's hard, technically, it's still soft.
I've watched a lot of porn. I've seen a lot of cock slapping. I've never seen a tooth come out. Unless maybe she had gums cancer. Right. If you hit somebody like, you should say, if you got cancer of the gums, I'll knock your tooth out.
I'll knock your tooth out, baby.
But you can do that with anything.
All right, well, you want to hear more? Let's hear more.
Please,
he has 4 inches of what?
Yeah, baby. Yeah, some women don't like it that wide.
Oh, 4 inches wide.
Yeah, that's right, yeah. You think it's a fairy tale? Well, puff the magic dragon, baby.
What does that mean?
Tell Pinocchio a lie.
Okay.
I'm the magic beans, dog, baby. Fee, fi, fo, fum, lay on down, and I'll make you. You know what I'm gonna do for you.
Don't say it.
Yeah. Oh, baby, I love you so good, your neighbor will have a smoke. That's right.
I love you so good.
I did a girl so good, the police came 3 times. That's right, baby.
Is he doing a Negro voice also?
Yeah.
We didn't even notice that through the bad material. I believe he's doing a Negro voice.
How long is this bit? Because someone is actually telling us to listen to the whole thing. It's funny.
No, he's not. I like the way he wouldn't say come.
How much longer?
2.5 more minutes.
Oh, my dear sweet Jesus Christ. Where did he go?
He left.
He ran away. You motherfucker. This doesn't get funny. And that call was from Oklahoma. The Midwest, you people, you better step up because other people are making you look bad. That is not funny.
Yeah.
Especially when you say, I'll love you so good, your neighbor will have a smoke.
How about fuck?
Come on, man. You're doing a whole bit about being a great fuck.
It's a big cock. It's a big dick joke. It's a big dick joke you're doing.
That's not harder to be clean when you're doing that. It's not harder. It's harder to be really original and really funny. And it's like, conceptually, maybe the bit's a good idea, but...
All right, well, why don't we listen a little more? It's supposed
it's
to
got
get
a catchphrase.
It's supposed to get funny.
The whole catchphrase. I love
it. Oh, good,
man.
Your neighbor will have a smoke. That's right.
That's right.
Yeah, I did a girl so good, the police came three times. That's right, baby. I'm the love master, baby. Yeah, you can go to school on me, baby. I'll graduate magna cum laude. That's right, baby.
Can you dig it?
Yeah. What are you laughing? You like French food? Well, bon appetit, baby. Yeah, we'll have safe sex. Go get me a hefty bag. Yeah, well, hey, you into Star Wars? Come on up here and Chewbacca.
Oh, no. No, he didn't.
We got to stop that for a second. Mike from Canada just doesn't get what we're all about. Mike in Canada, what's up?
Hey, man, it seems like you guys hate anybody who might get over in the Midwest or in the fucking South.
No, we don't.
Any
no, we don't. Is, no, we don't. You're wrong.
Well,
Okay,
I'm wrong. Check this out. I've heard that guy a lot on the Comedy Channel.
Of course you have.
Yeah.
I know, and that means I'm a fucking Midwesterner.
No, go ahead.
Just means you're a dope.
Jim, I love
Richard Pryor's from the Midwest, you jackass. It's nothing against the Midwest. Pryor's from Peoria, Illinois.
Okay, and fucking Richard Pryor's the exception to the rule, and he's a legend, okay? I'm not saying nobody funny came out of the Midwest, but it seems, Jim, like anybody that's not a fucking comedy seller... comic from New York, you fucking shit on him because
really, really stupid. Like Brian Regan, who I always say is great. What are you talking about,
Jim?
What are you talking about?
Brian Regan is a regular on our show, by the way.
There's a lot of guys out there like Schumacher who's a funny. He's a funny fucking
dude.
Guy,
this
man.
Is hack.
Dude, I didn't say he's not a funny guy. I don't know his act. I'm going by what I'm hearing right now is not good.
He harder than
good.
Chinese algebra.
Harder than Chinese algebra.
You're gonna say that isn't a fucking hack old joke, dude?
Maybe it's kind of fucking hack, but it can
kind of no. Admit it. That is an old fucking hack joke.
You know what, man?
No. Tell me what comedians I've trashed. Tell me. Who?
I hate it when you guys do this shit. You want me to recall something totally specific?
You are fucking saying something, so I'm asking you about it.
You're the one that brought this to the table, not us. Like, who do we trash that's clean? Who?
You know what? I'm gonna start keeping notes so that I can recall.
Well, dude, if you're gonna call somebody, I'm asking you who, because I don't trash comedians that aren't from the Comedy Cellar. I trash bad comedy.
It seems like anybody who's just a fucking a guy who's out there pounding the road doing these shitty clubs.
Really? Like Larry the Cable Guy, who I fucking defended? Like Larry the Cable Guy, who's as Midwest as you can get, who I defended and I smashed all the alternative comics for bashing him? Like him, stupid?
Yeah, Larry's been on our show. Brian Regan's been on our show. It's a taste thing. If you like Craig Shoemaker, so be it. We think he's a hack, or at least this bit is a hack.
He's been living off this bit
for 12 years.
I guess you're right that it might be hack, but it's like it seems to me like it's just over the top. Like holy fuck, does it really fucking piss you off?
Yes,
it does.
Really? Are you listening to that? Like, dude, I don't know what Shoemaker's act is like. I've never met the guy, but listening to that little bit, I've heard his name on the circuit for years. And when you say I'll love you so good, your neighbors will have a smoke. I don't know. It just doesn't.
Everybody knows what he's saying,
Mike,
right?
Exactly. So why not just say it,
Mike? I don't know Craig Shoemaker's act for the most part, but this bit sucks. And we do call out people for being
hacked. It's his benchmark bit.
It's his benchmark bit. He might be a funny guy. I don't know. I've never seen him live. But I mean, I'm listening to this thing, and I can't believe this was voted the best routine by the XM Nation. Are you kidding me?
Why wasn't Gallagher voted?
Best routine. There's a comic. Funny if he says, "I'm gonna blow my fucking load right in your face."
No, the whole bit. I don't like the whole bit. Do you actually laugh when you hear that, Mike?
Mike.
You know what, man? I do. I'm sorry.
Then you're a dummy, and I hope your family winds up in Paul Bernardo's basement.
Wow.
You fucker.
Paul Bernardo.
Wow, you went
Canada
local for
joke.
Canada. I like
going
it.
Going local. I love it.
What makes him even
Mike, let me say something, please. You listen to the comedy channels a lot, right?
Yeah, I'm on the road a lot, so I mean...
All right, you listen to the Comedy Channels a lot. You're trying to tell me this bit by Craig Shoemaker, the Love Master, is the best routine you've heard on the Comedy Channels. I don't care. We're not looking for a dirty comic. I'm just saying the best routine that you've heard on the Comedy Channels, dirty or clean.
No.
That's what we're getting at to begin with.
Yeah, you see, no, you're right.
We're being uber critical, yes, because this was voted the best routine of the fucking year by the XM Nation.
Well, then, isn't it fucking more important to fucking rag on the X? Yeah, okay, I understand what you're saying.
We're ragging on the bit, dude. Have you ever heard Louis Black? Have you heard Louis Black? I mean, Louis C.K.?
Black, fucking Louis Black kills me.
Louis C.K.?
Yeah, Louis C.K., I love that.
Dave Attell?
Joe Rogan.
Wait, hold on, Dave Attell?
Yes.
Okay, all comedy seller comics. All of them.
Believe me, I'm not saying those guys aren't funny. I think those guys are fucking
Mike.
Hilarious.
All right, you made your point, Mike. Thank you.
But I just thought it was like fucking disingenuous to just go like way over the top.
No, it wasn't at all.
No, dude. Not at all. We're not like pushing this one at all.
I very rarely trash comedians by name because I have a certain bond with comics, and I don't even dislike Shoemaker. I don't know him. I just that I'm hearing right now, I've heard about so many years, and I don't like it because it's just too purposefully family clean, and it's just bugging me.
Yeah, but don't you think there's a fucking good place for that? If a guy
in fucking church basements, yes.
No. If a guy stuck doing places in the like smaller venues in smaller regions, right? I'm not gonna quit. I hate.
Dude, he's got a big following. Craig Shoemaker has a following. He's not an anonymous comic.
He's not playing dumps all the time. Stop.
He has a lot of people fans.
But I think he realized at a certain point that he had to fucking, mainstream it a little bit.
But mainstream is fine.
We don't care about mainstream.
Brian Regan is one of the best mainstream ever, and he's hysterical. This is hack.
We're taking issue to the fact that this was voted the best routine.
It's a hack catchphrase
in the comedy category
that he made a song out of, and he's using old hack jokes in it.
I know.
All right, Mike.
Yeah,
thanks.
I know. Maybe.
All right.
Oh, Canada.
I hung up on him.
Yeah.
You should have.
Enough. But the guy, there's a guy on here that's...
He did say something, though, that... I have noticed there are times, sometimes we'll be ragging on something and I'll get home and listen to the replay, or I'll hear it a few days later or whenever we replay it, and I'll listen to myself and go, why the fuck am I so worked up about that? Like, I'll hear myself going, so, why don't they just stop doing that? And it's about like chewing gum or something really useless. I'll be like, boy, I sure was passionate that day about that.
And I don't think we're being that over the top. We're just yucking the bit.
Yeah, it's just...
Because it was voted the best routine. Let's not forget that, because there's a few other people saying it's a good bit.
Tell them to shut the fuck up. I'm listening to it.
A lot of people saying that they hate it, too. Scarecrow from Houston says it all. This fucking bit is filled with jokes. Ugh. Updated.
I just know it's here it is. Hack bit.
I know what.
Hold on. This fucking bit is filled with jokes you get emailed from your great aunt.
Yeah, with attachments.
I know a good bit when I hear it. People are going, this is a good bit. I'm listening to this for the first time ever.
Hey, and if
I'm not enjoying it.
And if people out there enjoy it, then so be it. I'm not trying to change.
Comedy is subjective, but then there's also things that are like, this is, it's hack.
Comedy is subjective. Hack. But it's almost like, as a comic, at least I hope I can at least distance myself enough to recognize something that's funny. Like, again, Mooney's an example I use a lot. He's a guy I don't agree with at all, but I acknowledge the guy's a great comedy writer. You can't say he's not a funny joke writer. He's always topical. He's great at what he does.
Mm-hmm.
Not my fucking vibe, but I respect what he does, and I know it's good.
All right, why don't we go to more of the Craig Shoemaker bit? There's only a little more time.
Man, there's some people staring at me right now.
I'm looking for one laugh, by the way. One laugh.
What the hell happened to him?
I'm out of character there. Yeah.
What?
Those girls, too.
Of course they are.
And all the girls.
Jesus. They look at me going, where'd the minivan guy go? No mini right here, baby.
Oh, boy.
That's right. This ain't no guppy. I'll free Willie. That's right, baby. Yeah.
Okay, stop that right there. Stop that. Who the fuck is laughing at I'll free Willie?
I'm laughing at your anger.
Because, dude, I'm annoyed that people are saying this is a great bit.
I know.
When it's all fucking innuendo and puns and fucking little... Come on, dude.
All right, let's continue. I'm looking for one laugh.
Baby. That's right. This ain't no guppy. I'll free Willie. That's right, baby. Yeah, oh, yeah. I'll have you breathing heavier than Ruben stuttered on a Stairmaster. That's right, baby. Yeah. What are you laughing at? That's me tapping you on the shoulder right now. Baby. Yeah. Don't turn your head. You'll get a black eye. That's right.
He's got a big cock,
that was
Jimmy.
So gross. Oh my God! Erase.
Well, you guys got the check. Suddenly, it's not so funny. Is it last call?
I'm talking to you, baby.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, don't you ignore me, baby. Yeah.
Why?
I'll jog your memory. You remember me. You want me to go away? You want your wish? You got to rub the lamp. Go ahead. Leave the room. I'll bend it around the corner back there.
His big dick, Jimmy.
Yeah, that's cool. Big cock. I get it.
His big cock.
I'm so sorry. Erase.
Oh, these women just love
keep
the dick.
Keep that big mouth open, baby. Yeah, I'll give you the gag order.
That was a horrible visual.
No, it was a horrible
seriously,
audio
don't
experience.
Seriously, encourage him. Erase.
Wow. See, whatever a comedian to me just continually, like, chides himself for his own naughtiness.
Yeah.
Like, or when a comedian continually, like, slaps his own hand and goes, I can't believe I just went there.
Oh,
guys,
oh,
I don't know
now.
What are you doing? The fuck is that?
Awful. It's awful, is what it is.
I would be interested to hear the rest of his act, because this is the bit that he got
known
from.
That's his benchmark bit.
So maybe the rest of the act is different. I don't know. I can't judge his whole act. I've never heard it.
Well,
whatever happened to the guy that used to use the bullhorn all the time? Remember Mr. Bullhorn?
Glenn Super, he died.
Is he dead?
I think he died of cancer. Yeah, he was in Long Island. He was a nice guy. I worked with him once. Not the reaction I was expecting. That news.
Oh, I'm sorry. How did he die? That's terrible. I'm sorry.
Let's get Craig Shoemaker on the phone.
Okay.
Holy shit. Is that funny?
I don't care.
I don't even want to trash the guy.
Well,
man.
Supposedly he admitted it's a dopey bit.
Ladies and gentlemen, my hair is falling out.
Oh, no.
What would Mr. Bullhorn do?
Doctor, I have a big tumor. Can you take it out?
Oh, Mr. Bullhorn. I'm sorry if you knew him, Jimmy.
I know. I worked with him once many years ago.
Yeah.
He was a nice dude, man. I didn't know him, though. I didn't know him.
Steven from Arizona, what's up?
Hey, good morning, guys.
I feel all bad now. Yes.
Hey, Jim. Jim, you know, as most comics do, I just want to break down the eighth wall if I can steal Opie's bit. But
wow. That
bit is riddled with stock lines.
Yeah, there's a lot of... Again... Certain lines, I give a certain amount of leeway to any old bits because you don't know like how stock something was before someone. Like if a guy's been doing a bit 20 years, certain lines right. May not have been hacked when he was first started doing them. So
harder than Chinese algebra.
No, that one. Yeah, I learned that one.
I learned that in third grade, and I'm now 28 years old.
Yeah,
can I stand up?
Still looking like I'm out of college. Well, the other day I got proof.
What, sir?
What?
Can I stand up for the show?
Yeah.
They mentioned, the guy was implying that you guys only back comics that are friends of the show and, seller comics.
Oh, he was
Jimmy just paid a compliment to Lisa fucking Lampanelli. I mean, he really did pay her a compliment, and he's done it more than one time. He even paid a compliment. You guys, all three, have complimented Artie Lang.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We like dirty, we like clean. It's not like we just like dirty comics. That's ridiculous.
Dude, I like a good comedian. I don't just like dirty or clean. And comedians recognize normally other, or good comics. I mean, comics don't badmouth Chappelle, Attell. Louis Black's a really good stand-up. I mean, come on, man. We're in the business. We understand what's good.
Speaking of Louis Black, stand-up champion of 2006.
Yep. Louis is on fire this year.
Female was Lisa Lampanelli, best comic of the year, according to the XM Nation, and Louis Black got the male title. All right, we should stop right there, because there's too much anger. In the room.
Yeah, everyone's all angry now. We ended on an angry note. I like that.
You're angry?
I'm angry.